click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know what is actually a physical equilibrium, and in that case we have got to know that it is a state where we could find that the substance are present in an equilibrium phase. So that is the reason that we are going to talk about chemical equilibrium also. It is very similar to that one, but the only thing is in this case the chemical, the one is been reactant, that is been converted into product, and that product which is now been converted into reactant, that is we are talking about a reversible process. So this chemical equilibrium can be obtained in reversible process. How? Let us talk about it. So now let us understand what is chemical equilibrium. So it is defined as the state of a reversible chemical reaction at which the rate of forward reaction and the reverse reaction are equal, as well as the concentration of the reactant and the product have constant values. So this is known as chemical equilibrium. So let me give you an example of this one. We have talked about the chemical equilibrium earlier also, but with the help of this example, that is when nitrogen, it combines with that of the hydrogen, so there is a tendency to form ammonia, that is NH3. But we have to balance it, so for which we have to give a reaction in which the nitrogen and the hydrogen, they react so as to give NH3. But in this case we have found that whenever the nitrogen is been reacted with the hydrogen, therefore there are 3 moles of hydrogen that are been involved so as to give 2 moles of ammonia, that is NH3. So in this case the physical state is also been required to mention. So therefore this nitrogen is of gaseous phase, while that of the hydrogen also, while that of the that is ammonia also. So making this reaction to be known as a homogeneous reaction that we have did earlier also. But talking about this one, this is not a physical equilibrium. The reason behind that is because in this case the nitrogen and the hydrogen, they both are reacting with each other so as to give a different substance, and that's the reason that this is a chemical reaction. But in this case, as we could see that the symbol is been used, so this symbolizes that the rate of forward reaction and the rate of backward reaction, the both are almost same, and this has the tendency, that is the reaction or the reactant can give you the product as well as the product can give you the reactant. So that makes this to be known as a reversible reaction. But there will be a certain point or there will be a certain stage where we could find that the concentration of the reactant and the concentration of the product, they both attain an equal quantity, and that's the reason that this is called as chemical equilibrium. And the concentration, when we are talking about the concentration at suppose if a reaction attains a chemical equilibrium, then those concentration attains are known as basically equilibrium concentration. And the mixture where we could find that a stage where the reactant and the product, they both have equal concentration, or we could say as the mixture where we could find the both are of the same quantity, then that kind of mixture is been known as equilibrium mixture. So this is what I wanted to explain about the chemical equilibrium, but it is somewhere different from that of the physical equilibrium. And the reason is because in physical equilibrium there is no chemical change that it occurs, only the change that it occurs is the physical transition, or we could say as the phase. For example, like H2O, if H2O is present in a solid form, that is we are talking about ice, if that has been converted into a different phase like liquid water, so in this case the H2O is not been converting into something a different chemical, it has been composed of the same, that is 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom, making that to be called as the physical equilibrium. But meanwhile this one, this reaction or this kind of reaction where we could see that the chemical reaction occurs and we get a product, and even that product has capacity, and that product will be different from that of the reactant, and that product has the capacity or the tendency to give back again the reactant, so that is a reversible reaction, and in reversible reaction only we will get a chemical equilibrium. So this is what I was talking about, and talking about the rest of the part, that usually when a chemical equilibrium is been attained or we get a chemical equilibrium, then the rate of the forward reaction and the rate of the backward reaction, the both are almost the same. Yes, for example, if I differentiate this in terms of a forward reaction, then this could be called as when nitrogen and 3 moles of hydrogen, it will give you, that is 2 moles of NH3. But if I talk about the backward reaction, that is when 2 moles of NH3 has a tendency to give back N2 plus 3 moles of H2. So this is what I am talking about, the rate of reaction, and let me explain you with the help of an example or a general example that I am going to talk about, that is Suppose if we have a reaction, consider this one, that is A plus B, and if it is showing a chemical equilibrium or it is a reversible reaction, suppose if I am showcasing it. So A plus B has suppose tendency to give C plus D. So in this case, basically this is a reversible reaction, but this reaction has been divided into two parts, that is a forward reaction and a backward reaction. So when we are talking about a forward reaction, that means in this case A plus B is been converting into C plus D. While talking about the backward reaction, this will be C plus D that gives us A plus B. So we have recently mentioned that in chemical equilibrium, the rate of forward reaction and the rate of backward reaction, the both are same. So now we are talking about the rate of reaction actually. So the rate of reaction, it depends on the concentration of the reactant that we are talking about. So that's the reason that suppose in this reaction, that is in the forward reaction, as we could see that the concentration of suppose A and B, suppose it is more, then we could see that the rate of reaction will go on increasing. But since AB is in the reactant side, so we could see that as the time spends, then we could see the concentration of the AB, they go on decreasing, and that's the reason that the rate of the forward reaction also goes on decreasing. But meanwhile, when you are talking about when the C plus D, suppose it has been formed, and suppose C plus D is forming again A plus B, means I'm talking about a reversible reaction or I'm talking about a backward reaction. So in this case, as C plus D is a product that has been formed, and in the backward reaction, suppose if I'm talking about, then obviously we could get to know that as the time spends, then the concentration of C plus D, it goes on increasing. When it comes to A plus B, it gives C plus D. And that's the reason we could see that as the time increases, as the time is going on, we could see that the concentration of C plus D is going on increasing. And that's the reason that in backward reaction, we could see that as the time spends, then the rate of this reaction also goes on increasing. So let me give an example in this case by help of a diagram. So this is the graph that I have mentioned over here, and this showcases about the time and as the time moves on, and this is the rate. So suppose talking about the first, that is the forward reaction, then in this case we will get to know that A plus B is giving us C plus D. So as the time moves, we could see that the rate of the reaction, that is A plus B, that is converting into C plus D, it goes on decreasing. So therefore there will be decrease in the rate of reaction for A plus B, that is giving me C plus D. But meanwhile, if I'm talking about, that is the backward reaction, that is C plus D that gives us A plus B. So in this case, I could see as the time spends, then the rate increases. So that's the reason this backward reaction goes on increasing with respect to time, while the forward reaction, it goes on decreasing with respect to time when I'm talking about the rate. So therefore, there will be a certain point where we could find that the rate of forward reaction and the rate of backward reaction, the both are same. And this is the point where we could see that the rate and the rate of the forward and the rate of the backward reaction, the both are same. And this is the case that where we could find equilibrium, and basically we are talking about chemical equilibrium. So this is the position where we could find the chemical equilibrium, where the rate is almost constant for both the forward and the reverse or the backward reaction. And the mixture that has been obtained in that case is known as equilibrium mixture, as well as the concentration that we have got, because active masses are also known as concentration of the reactant as well as of the product. So even the both will be a constant value. So since we are talking about the constant that is concentration or equilibrium concentration, so even that could be maintained, or that could be given in the form of, as we have talked about, A plus B is giving me C plus D, and this is a reversible reaction, and at chemical equilibrium we could get that the concentration of the product and the ratio of the concentration of the product to the ratio of the concentration of the reactant, it would be a constant value. So therefore we could say that that constant value would be suppose K, and this is the active mass, that is concentration of C and concentration of D, that is this is the product, and this is the ratio that I have made for the concentration of the active masses of the reactant, that is A plus B. So therefore this value will be a constant value, and that kind of constant value is known as equilibrium constant. So this is what we will obtain when a chemical reaction occurs in a equilibrium. So this is what I wanted to talk about, the chemical equilibrium. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have understood that how a chemical equilibrium has been obtained. So I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.